In this video, you'll learn how to prepare the data for a neural network training and how to build, train, evaluate, and save a simple feed-forward neural network in KNIME Analytics platform. Let's jump into it. This workflow uses the famous Iris dataset to build a simple feed-forward neural network with one hidden layer to classify the three iris types. This is a multinomial classification task. Have a look at the data pre-processing. First, encode the target column. Convert the string categories to numbers. And transform them into an array. This will make it more easily usable by the network later on. Next, partition the data to the training, validation, and test sets. Finally, perform feature pre-processing according to the data and network type. This example has the simplest case. Since there are only numerical features, it's enough to normalize them to the range from 0 to 1. Next, define the network architecture. Start with the Keras input layer node. This node configures the input layer of the network, which is, in fact, an input tensor. You need to define the shape of the input tensor based on the training data. In this example, there are 4 numeric features. Therefore, set the input shape to 4 units. Next, add one hidden layer using the Keras dense layer node. This dense layer connects each unit of its input with its output units. In this example, the number of units is set to 8, and the activation function is ReLU. Finally, complete the network with another Keras dense layer node. This node defines the output layer of the network according to the output tensor. In the Iris dataset example, there are 3 classes to be predicted. Therefore, set the output shape to 3. The activation function to use for multinomial classification is the softmax. It defines the probability of each class. The feedforward neural network architecture is now ready. It has 3 layers with 4, 8, and 3 units in each layer. Now that the data are in the correct format, and the network architecture is defined, let's move to the training. The Keras network learner node defines the training parameters and trains the network. The node has 3 input ports, a model port for the defined network, a data port for the training data, and an optional port for the validation data sample. Have a look at its configuration. In the tab Input Data, select the 4 features that you want to use for the prediction. The conversion setting will transform the features into a format that is accepted by the network. These features are of type double, therefore select the option From Number Double. Next, in the tab Target Data, select the target column. Remember that the target column has been converted to a 1-element array during pre-processing. Thus, you can select the conversion From Collection of Number Integer to 1-hot Tensor to transform it into a 1-hot encoding. Here, you also need to select the loss function. You can choose between a standard loss function and our own custom loss function. Since this is a multinomial classification problem, select the categorical cross entropy. Finally, in the tab Options, define the training parameters. Train 100 epochs, set a training batch size to 5, use the shuffling option, and as an optimizer, use Atom with default settings for the learning rate. The node provides the interactive learning monitor view, where you can observe how the accuracy and loss are changing for training and validation data during the network training. You can observe the metrics in the line charts, in the view on the right side, or in the Keras log output. After the network is trained, let's make the predictions for the test data with the Keras network executor node. In the configuration of this node, set the input batch size equal to the size of the training batch. Select the input features, and select the conversion from number double. Besides, click the Add Output button and select the output layer. In this case, it's the second dense layer with the softmax activation. The output should be converted to number double. You can see that the node produces 3 new columns, which contain the predicted probability of each class, thanks to the softmax activation function. In order to get the final prediction, determine the class with the highest probability by using the many-to-one node. To yield only the number, we can further process the output with the expression node. Finally, you can assess the performance of the model with a score node. This model has an accuracy of 97%. If the performance is satisfying, save the model for deployment with a Keras Network Writer node. In this video, you've learned how to prepare the data for neural network training and how to build, train, evaluate, and save a simple feed-forward neural network in KNIME Analytics platform.